Hi, so shalom once again. This will be the next part of this particular lecture right here. And we're going to try to touch on that hour of tribulation, because a revelation had occurred to I and I while just doing the mass, you know, the whole 12 hours. First, let's get to 12 hours. Let's go to chapter 11 of Johannes, right? Let's be honest like Johannes. Let's go to chapter 11 and let's go to verse 9. We haven't left off on Yeshua's rebuke of Peter. You understand? His rebuke of Peter. I'm going to find out why. You understand why? Because some people are offended when we say the cannabis Christ, or when we liken Christ and the herb and the tree and the herb and the cannabis, right? And they didn't understand the Higgs boson, right? You know, the Higgs boson. So let's put this down right here. The kana, right? Boson, right, or the kana, right, the kana boson, right, or beson versus the Higgs boson, right, and that's about the God particle, right, the God particle, or the Jah, we'll call it the Jah particle, right, what's that Jah particle? The Bible calls it a deposit, right, if we look up that word deposit, we have the deposit. And that's another part, too, that we need to get into as well, the deposit. But we'll probably, if Yah wills, we'll do a little bit of detail on it. Because as we speak on these things and teach on these things, we also are growing ourselves. This is why when you love to do his will, you understand, he enriches you. He loves to give. You understand? Our Father, Abba, loves to give in Yeshua. He loves his Son, and he loves, right, he loves I and I in him and through him. So he doesn't see us when we are born again. He don't see all those things. He sees his Son. You understand? He looks for the measure, right? He looks for the measure of his Son. So we're going to deal with the deposit part, because there's it might not be translated as deposit in that sense, but we have that. Like when he says faith as a mustard seed. So let's look at it like that, as a mustard seed. But here we're going to talk about the hour of tribulation, right? The hour of tribulation. So Christ says right here, and this right here is the Metzaf Kedus, or the Book of the Seven Seals of His Imperial Majesty. Right, this is a IOTA program, and here's the King James Bible side by side. So in verse 9, Yesu sim meliso kenu ashera hulet sa'at aydelemin beken yemi melales binor yezihin alem burhan yayalina ay senakalim targum. Jesus, or Yeshua, answered, right? Are there not 12 hours in the day? If any man walk in the day, he stumbleth not, because he seeth, right, the light of this world. It says, majesty and his splendor is likened to the sun, you know, in his exalted power to the lion, in his divine person to the kings of Israel, and sometimes to God himself. But then it says in verse 10, right, so we have 11, 9, chapter 11, 119, so we have 12 hours. Then verse 10, it says, Belelit yemi melales binor gin, burhan, be'arusu selelele yisenak kalal alacho. But if a man walk in the night, without the light, right, he stumbleth. And see, the word stumble is interesting, because the word stumble also means he's offended. You know, it's like it says, if you rebuke a fool, he will hate you, but if you rebuke a wise man, he will love you. So should that mean you should first find out what kind of man he is? No, you don't find out until you rebuke, until there's a need to rebuke. And then you'll find out what kind of person you're dealing with, right? Because there is no light, there is no burhan, right? There is no light in him. So truly there is not no, remember, burhan and na salam. So there must be light and peace. So there needs to be that light, right? in order for the peace, so you can walk in the way of peace. That's why it says the way of peace they have not known. So the way of peace they have not known. So what's interesting, and we ask this sometime, I wonder whether Petros or Peter was offended. You understand? When Yeshua said right here, get thee behind me, Satan. Remember, he turned to Peter. Come on, I was trying to say, you know, earthly Christian lady, Christian folks trying to say, oh, no, he didn't call Peter a devil. I think I said devil. I think I admit it. Hopefully I did that. I was a little bit wrong technically terminology, because devil and Satan is a little different. There's a nuance there. Satan means enemy or opposer. You understand? Or opposition. And diablos mean liar or slanderer. Right? So he didn't call him a liar or slanderer. He called him an opposition. Satan. Right? He said, thou art an offense. Right? And what? An offense to me, for thou savorest not the things that be of God. Right? He's spiritual faith. Remember the connection of the church and religiosity? He is spiritual faith. I mean, he got a little bit of it. But he is looking at things, right, according to the way men look at it. And Christ says, for thou savorest not the things that be of God, but those that be of men, right? Those that be of men and people. You know what I'm saying? Those that be of the, you know, the religious denominationalism and the religious beliefs of the world. Right, so he said that Peter was an offense to him. After calling him, you are, I call you Peter, Petros, you're a rock upon this Petra, I will build my church. He's the builder. Yeshua's the builder. See, folks say, I built a church. No, even the Beta Rastafari, even I and I church, may we allow Yeshua, you understand, let Yeshua build it. Cause that's the only way it's going to stand. If it's built on his word, not on our word, not on what we do, you understand, but on what he is able to do in us when we make our wills obedient to good influence. So that be of God, right? Right? So he doesn't savor the things that be of God, but those that be of men. If you look in the NET, the New Translation, it says, but he turned and said to Peter, get behind me, Satan. Didn't he say that same thing to the Satan, the devil in the wilderness, like in the when he went to fast and pray, the Spirit led him up to, right? You are a stumbling block. In other words, you're a blockhead. Peter, you're talking like a blockhead. Now imagine we said that to a brother or a sister, you know, about something he said because it's not in alignment with his majesty. Oh, the offenses will offense. They'll be offended, right? Well, they should be. In truth, it's an offense, but not a sin, because you are not setting your mind, right, on God's interests, but on man's. You know, we could stop this lecture really right here and ask ourselves, Rastafari, brothers, sisters, are we setting our mind on God's interests or on man's, on God's interests or what man thinks? You know, if we look at how the movement has almost grinded to almost a halt or a stagnation and inertia, you know what I'm saying? It's because of that setting our mind, right? Our mind on man's interests. You understand? And not Jah's interests. You know, everyone trying to be the next Bob Marley. You understand? Or trying to do these kind of things out in the world. Now, Burhanus Alansi, he was called for that because his work still, you understand, his work still follow to this very day. Verse 24, then said Yeshua, Jesus, to his disciples. So he said this to Peter. Now, is he going to call his disciples the Satans? No, he says, if any man will come after me, right? If any man will come after me, right? If any of us will come after, well, he's already gone before, so we're all coming after him, but if we can seek to follow him, right? It says, let him deny himself, deny his own way. So you see the context here? He was saying that Peter was looking at things from so-called man's best, but not Jah's blessed. He was looking at things from the way other people saw things. So we have to ask ourselves. You see, if you're not going to be honest, you understand, before, like honest like Johannes, in other words, you're not going to be in that grace because Johannes, Jah's Hannah, you understand, Johanna, you understand, basically means the grace of Jah. You understand? That's why he was so well beloved. If you're able to receive it, receive. Make him deny himself. Deny, let go of your ego. Let go of your ego, which is probably the most difficult thing, as we said before. It's probably the most difficult thing as us as brethren, or as men, you understand, to truly acknowledge Yeshua as our Savior. Honestly. You see, a lot of men are maybe not mature enough. They can't see it, really. Because it's also when we look at him even as being like one of us. You understand? It's like I've actually gone through heated reasonings and debates with some of my, you know, most beloved brethren. You understand? And we hotly, you understand? We hotly argued, you understand, these particular issues. You understand? We hotly reasoned these particular issues. Like, well, yeah, but he was just like me, and it's not understanding the reason for Jah's number one son, right? Who is Jah's number one son? It's Yeshua HaMoshiach, because we only become brethren, really, not because we all have locks, and only because we have a father. We have one father and one elder brother. It's a relationship there, and we have to be conscious of that, and we have to affirm that and not be afraid to declare that. Because we declare that we bind things, we bind up on earth, and know this, we bind up spiritual wickedness too, when we declare it. You understand? When we deny and suppress it, we give evil, we give a place to the devil. That's why it says, give no place to the devil. Bind it up. Declare the truth. You understand? In season and out of season. You understand? And anyone that asks you for a reason of the hope that is in you, you should be able to. You understand? Share with them. You might not know a lot. You understand? You might not have mastered the Nabah Bait, the basic Hahus, just yet. You understand? And you're trusting Yah in Yeshua, Jah in Joshua. You understand? To give you more grace and for that gift, because language is a gift. You understand? We didn't go to no college. You understand? And learn this. You understand? They didn't. You know, they didn't teach this. You understand? They didn't teach this in so-called college. Let's move that other guy out of the picture for a moment and just put Yeshua right here, just so we, you know, so we can recognize. You understand? So we see him as just one of us. You understand? We see him as, well, he is one of us, but we have to remember the precedence. They call it precedence. You understand? He is before I and I. He is our big brother. Yeshua HaMoshiach is I and I. It's I and I, big brother. So what do we have here? You understand? What do we have here? Christ is saying, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself. Make him let go of his ego. And take up his cross and follow me. In other words, do as I do is what Yeshua is saying. But first you have to learn. You understand? You have to learn of me, he says. You know, who can resist an invitation so full of compassion? The only answer I can give is a fool. Brothers and sisters, you know, I've been foolish. Yeah, you know, I kind of struggled and wrestled with, like some of y'all may want to wrestle with it and bring all these worldly philosophies that are not in His Majesty's interest. His Majesty's interest, you understand, is Yeshua. You understand? His Majesty's interest is Christ. He tells you in the Oriana Fallaci interview, he says what gives him greatest pleasure, you understand, as emperor of Ethiopia is to serve, you understand, as a father serveth his son. That's an astounding statement here. As a father serveth his son. You know, what does that mean? You understand, it should be clear and obvious for those of spiritual faith. It should be a confirmation or affirmation to the brothers and sisters that have that deposit of the Spirit, right? For whosoever will make his wills obedient to good influences, that's the King, right? But the Son says, right, the Lord of Lords, the Adonai HaAdonim, he says, for whosoever will save his life shall lose it. You know, going, I don't do that, I'm going to get in trouble. I'm going to get in trouble for that. You're going to lose it. You're going to lose it. You're not going to be able to live even the life that you got. You understand? And it says, after the colon, it says, and whosoever will lose his life You know what I'm saying? That means the old man, the old way. You know what I'm saying? The astray way before you was born again. You know what I'm saying? Today, right? It says, will lose his life. Whosoever will lose his life for my sake shall find it. In other words, whosoever will jeopardize himself. You know what I'm saying? Even I had gone forward and putting out these things where we're speaking some really heavy truths. You know what I'm saying? That we go east and west and don't see no one saying this. And it's like right there. And when I speak to brothers and sisters and others, many of the brothers and sisters, many of y'all get some or most of this already. And I wonder, how come you're not saying it? You know what I'm saying? Doing. You may not do a video every day or as many videos as we produce, but put it out. You understand? Put it out. You understand? Share it. You understand? Overload the prints of the ear. Cause the prince of the ear to fall. Mm-hmm. By binding him up and binding his works up here on the earth. But be in the true good news, the true Wengel, the true gospel. So we see how this all connects right here. Don't we? He goes on in verse 26. For what is a man profited? Oh my. Well, I just got like, you know, people say the chills. I don't know if I call it the chills. But you feel it like in your solar plexus, in the pit, you know, of your belly, you know. I just felt it right here because let's go to this right here. And you need to get your updated copy of this, my brothers and sisters, right? There's a minor update. So if you have the old one, it's just a couple of graphics that we had to, you know, update. You see this right here? This is the Kabbalah tree, the real tree of life. You know what I'm saying? The Kabbalah. You know what I'm saying? The Kabbalah tree right there, Lalabella. You know what I'm saying? Which basically is what was said when the bees, you understand, was around Lalibella, right? And said, will not eat. Albella. You understand? Will not eat. You understand? In other words, when you're in Yeshua, Satan cannot eat you. Death cannot eat you. Mm-hmm. But like our big brother, you understand? Death is eaten up. Death is swallowed up in the what? The victory. In the victory. You understand? In the victory. So we declare. We don't say, well, it don't seem like victory going on around. It don't seem like that. Because I walk by sight, not by faith. I believe seeing is believing. That is the most idiotic thing, and it's just amazing how they can hoodwink and bamboozle people to, you know, say that even so-called Christian people. You understand? A lot of so-called Christian nominal, Christian pseudonymous people, falsely so-called Christian people will be hoodwinked and bamboozled with it. But Christ says, for what is a man profited if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? What shall a man give? In other words, after he's lost his soul, right, and to who? The devil, Satan. What can he give now that he lost his soul? What do you think he can give to the devil to get back his soul? You understand? He can give nothing. You understand? Because the soul is very, very precious. You understand? And a lot of folks sell it, you understand, before they know what it is. You understand? And may Christ have mercy, you understand, on these and those. Let us get a picture right here, you understand, of our Father, our God Father, the King of Kings. Okay, this is like Nibiru, you understand? It's Christ and his kingly character right there. Let us hear, you understand? Let us hear, you understand, the words of the King of Kings. I want the King of Kings to, you know, so you know who we're talking about right here. You know what I'm saying? So everyone, right? Heathen, sheathen, you understand? You know, because it's for all still. But all may not want to receive it, and that's their problem. You know what I'm saying? Don't let it be your problem. You know what I'm saying? That's their problem. Don't let their indecisiveness hold you back or hold you down. You know what I'm saying? That's why he said, if you love mother, father, sister, brother, you know what I'm saying, more than me, he says, you're not worthy of me. Let's let's continue with the Son's word right here, verse 27, Matthew 16:27. It says, "For the Son of Man shall come in the glory of his Father with his angels," right, "with his angels, and then he shall reward every man according to his works." 28, verily is interesting, because if you look at the Hebrew, it's really amen. He's really saying amen. He's saying amen, I say to you. Well, let's see if we can just show you this right here, because it's always good to, so you will see this, and not just me say it and ones, you know, believe it. Because we don't want you to take my word alone for it. My testimony is true, but you need to see the fact for yourself. You understand? Don't be saying, "Well, he said it." You understand? He said it. You know, but check it out. All right, give me some, let there be light, right? Right here. You see this right here? Now, this is right here. This is that verse. This is the Hebrew Bible. "Verily, I say to you." Let's see if we can find this. He says, amen. Right there, amen. That's amen. He says, amen, Omar. You can say, if you believe their pointing of the letters, ani lekem, amen, Omar, ani lekem, or amen, Omar, ani lekem. You understand? For verily, he says, amen, I'm saying to you the amen. I'm testifying, the amen is testifying to you. Verily, I say to you, there be some standing here which shall not taste of death till they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom. Now, that seems like a very amazing kind of thing, right? They would not taste of death. You know what I'm saying? Till they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom. And this is not scripture so much, but based on what the Holy Spirit has shown I see that that's connected with the fascist invasion of Ethiopia. Mm-hmm. It almost brings tears to my eyes to even think about it. But there were some, wow, you know, there were some who were alive, you know what I'm saying, all of that time until that particular, because there was a war in heaven going on. There was a spiritual war. That's what's hidden from most people's eyes. They know, well, Ethiopia was invaded, but there was a spiritual war going on simultaneously at the very same time. He said, whatever you bind on earth, you understand, you bind in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth, you loose in heaven. The power of affirmation, what you affirm. Like when he asked his master, did you ever lose hope of returning and being restored and upon the throne of David? And he says he never lost hope. He always had big hope. You know what I'm saying? He never lost hope. And he actually spoke in English. He broke a little bit of, well, I won't say broke it, but what they call breaking protocol. And he spoke English, and you could tell that was with, you know, that was the spirit just coming out just rawly in the language that we could understand. You know, so that all wouldn't have to depend on the translator. You understand? It'll be very, very clear. Now, this portion that we read from Matthew chapter 16 and mainly verse 26. Hear what his imperial majesty, right, you know, he speaks on this very particular issue, which is, you know, when he asks about what does it profit a man, you know what I'm saying, to gain the whole world, you know what I'm saying, he warns them, you know what I'm saying, he warns them of this particular time to come today. Man sees all his hopes and aspirations crumbling before him. He is perplexed and knows not whither he is drifting. Where are we drifting, folks? You know, I mean, look what's going on. Where are we drifting? While they're getting their contingency and secret underground bases and stocking up on food, and they have us looking at this so-called politics and politrics, and, you know, and both of them have their secret places to go to, which is probably well stocked up. You understand? You know, but the rest of us, you know, they're blacking out Nibiru in the sky. Mm-hmm. And Nibiru is coming from Regalis. it's coming from the lion part, you know, the Anvesa. I mean, just think about how all this just keeps kind of hitting it on. It's like if it's a rhyme, this is like the 64 bars, you understand, of a rhyme, right? But as Matthew says that today man sees all his hopes, everything he expects, all his aspirations, all that he is perspiring and think he's inspired to attain, crumbling before him. He is perplexed. He overs, and then Babylon hooks him on pharmaceuticals, right? And then now he's seeing demons and bugging out, right? And he knows not whither he is drifting. Mm-hmm. Every day you ask brothers, yo, what's up? Oh, same old, same old. The same old, same old. Don't you know that when you say that, you're basically reinforcing the curse? You're reinforcing the curse. I mean, even when I hear my brethren say it, you know, sometimes I've even said it kind of like to get along, to go along. But as that spirit grows in you, you feel real weird, I would say. You feel real like it's like you know you did something wrong by saying it. You know what I'm saying? Because your words in Christ are not just any old words. It's like, in a sense, that is, there's a potentiality there to fall from grace if you keep doing that. Mm-hmm. Like sometimes we say, well, how come so-and-so has got turned out of the way? It's probably by the words. We have to prune I and I words. But, his Matthew says, he must realize humanity, mankind, and all kinds of man, including the original man, I and I must realize that the Bible, the Metzav Kedus, is his refuge. Remember in the previous Torah portion, there were cities of refuge? Well, there's a refuge, right? Or we can say a grace, to find grace, right? From grace to grace, from the word to the living grace. And the rallying point, right? The rallying point for all humanity. But notice it said for all humanity. You know what I'm saying? Not for the demons. The demons can't rally to this. That's why they suppress God talk and Bible. You know what I'm saying? And they act funny when they know that you are in Yeshua. You notice that? Folks act kind of funny. In it, man will find the solution. You understand the solution? What is the solution to his present difficulties and guidance? Rastafari one time said guidance. We have to bring that forward again, guidance. And overstand, when we say guidance, we're not just throwing the word out there. We're talking about may God guide you by your study and what you grow in the word and with his spirit. Guidance for his future action. Like, what are we to do? What is our continuity of God's kingdom? We who have that deposit, that John particle, you understand? What is our future action to be? And unless he accepts with clear conscience, guiltiness rests on them conscience. Oh, yeah. Yeah, like, guiltiness rests on their conscience, right? Why? Because they haven't come to the Mesco. You know, they haven't come to the feet of Christ. They haven't killed it. You know what I'm saying? And they haven't seized hold on the tree of life. You know what I'm saying? The tree of life. You know what I'm saying? The living tree of life. To accept it, we have to accept it. That means amen it with a clear conscience. Not amen it because everybody else amen it, but amen it with a clear. Because if you don't, it won't work for you. You could be a good actor and act the part and stuff, and all of us can go for it, but it's not working for you in you. That's why some folks say, oh, this is a religion thing. This, you know, because the guiltiness, the conscience is not clear. Mm-hmm. Mainly because they haven't come to Christ. They're trying to establish their own righteousness. Maybe Ital, you know, your locks, how long the locks are, John Music. You know what I'm saying? Or any one of how much red, gold, and green, or herb, how much cannabosum they smoke. You know what I'm saying? But they're not smoking it in the right order. They're not burning it, rather. We don't smoke. It smokes. You know what I'm saying? They're not burning that aishens in the right order. You know what I'm saying? Even calling the aishens weed. You know what I'm saying? About, you're cursing the herb by calling aishens weed. You know what I'm saying? By calling it weed. You know? So unless he accepts with clear conscience the Bible and its great message, what kind of message is in the Bible? So the other Bible is just, you know, just like I see the same thing in the Mayans, and I see it in the Aztecs, I see it in the I Ching, you know, I see it on Webbot, you know, I see it elsewhere, you know, there's a lot of other kind of, you know, and the Hindus and there's these other folks that talk Buddha, you know, right? Yeah. But yeah, I'm Rastar. Yeah, you Rastar. You know what I'm saying? You're the Ra'ah Kokeb. And the Ra'ah Kokeb for the evildoers is Nibiru. You know what I'm saying? That's going to pour out wrath, you know what I'm saying, on the disobedience. You know what I'm saying? But for us in Yeshua HaMoshiach, we have to look forward. Our hope and expectation, you know what I'm saying, as we pray and work, is for him to pour that spirit and give us that guidance, you know what I'm saying, so we can accept with a clear conscience the Bible and this great message. Otherwise, His Majesty says that he or ones and ones who don't accept it in that order cannot hope. They cannot expect nothing. That's why people like same old, same old. That's driving them further into the pit, right? They cannot hope for salvation. You understand? True salvation, not just salvation as a word or as a gimmick or something like that. We're speaking about true Medan. You understand? We're speaking about the Medan, right? For my part, Negusa Neges says, I glory in the Bible. For my part, he says right here, you can see it right there. For my part, right, I glory in the Bible. For my part, I glory in the Bible. You know, so do you glory in the Bible, right? If you don't, it's because you need to first get your house, your spiritual house, in order. And this is especially for Rastafari, for I and I, Rastafari brothers and sisters, because Rastafari of every nation, as we said before, you are the elect. You know what I'm saying? You are the elect of whatever nation you are. So there's a high and a heavy responsibility, but also a grace that's upon us. So we have to walk in the light. You understand? Because he is that light. You understand? And now, bringing us full forward, right? Bringing us full forward to this, the hour of tribulation, this present day. And we actually have gone through all this actually to come kind of full cipher right here to the candelabrum, right? Or I keep saying candelabrum, you could have told me, to the lampstand. There's a difference between lampstand and candelabrum. Menorah. Let's just call it what it is in Hebrew, a menorah. You know what I'm saying? The menorah, right? That's over. And it's interesting, Bamarinya, menoria means to live. Menoria. Menoria is like a dwelling place, the menoria. You know what I'm saying? So in the Hebrew, it's the lamp, it's the light. So everyone, why Yeshua is always speaking about light, you know what I mean? Because he is the light. You know what I'm saying? He is the light. So let's go to Revelation, where we were in Revelation. And perhaps in the fall, we'll show you how in the Fikari Yesus, right, in the Fikari Yesus, this comment or Nibiru can be interpreted in there, in the context of it. You know what I'm saying? And we have some of that here, and we'll translate when we get to that portion. So we'll speak in the tongue, you know what I'm saying? Speak to God, and then we'll translate, you know what I'm saying, for the brothers and the sisters, according to Corinthians chapter 14, right? So we have the Hallel Psalms, right? The Hallel Psalms. Right? Some say the Hallel, the Ilil, the Hallelujah, the Ililu, the Ilil to Yah, the Ililil to He who is who He is. You understand? Not to the fallen light bearer. You understand? Not to the fallen light bearer. Let's bring that up again. The fallen light bearer, that's an example of the fallen light bearer. You understand? Right there. You understand? And you can judge it by its fruit. Remember Cesar Borgias, we began this whole series right here, this whole series of vids right here. And brothers and sisters, and ones who are able to download it, download this series, put it together, you know what I'm saying, and share it with others who are willing to learn. You know what I'm saying? Feel free to do that. Download any of the series, put them together, put them out. If you're up to it, do some covers for it. You understand? If one takes a donation, which is reasonable on it, you understand, use that for one's church or one's gathering. You understand, or Bible study. You understand, use that for the very young or the very old. You understand, the ones that really can't do for themselves. You understand, without help. You understand, the able-bodied people, they need to grow up in Yeshua. You understand, and recognize who they are and what their purpose is. So, into this area of scripture right here. Let's take this down. You know what I'm saying? And so we have the Hallel, right? The Hallel Psalms, right? For it's a prophetic timetable for the Great Tribulation. Well, Helena Lehman, she basically did it right here in her diagram that we utilize. You understand? Using Judaic and Christ Man liberties, Christian liberties, right, to utilize all of this work right here. You understand? Because all things are through him and to him, right? So right here is Psalm 110, right, 111, 112, 113, and following 2010, 2011, 2012, 2013. At the center point is 2014, Psalm 114, and some Rastafari. Some of our brothers and sisters are working towards that day in the different HIM institutions, and support your HIM institution. See if there's any HIM, His Imperial Majesty institution in your area, and if one want a fellowship, one can start one, but support the HIM institution in your area, or of your choice, but especially in your area, you understand? And we're going to give a couple of pointers on, you know, some of the preparation. Mm-hmm. For this time, everybody's looking at this candle right here, which has connected with it 112. Right now, these are the Psalms of Ascent, what's known as the Psalms of Ascent. And in the Mezmor de David, our parallel Bible, right, with the Haile Selassie, that was printed for the 50th, the Jubilee, right? For the 50th Jubilee of the printing of from 1961, you understand? So in 2011, from September to September, you understand, through a portion of the year. Well, actually, we're still in that time, actually. Mm-hmm. Well, actually, because September hasn't come forward just yet, when we're in our proper order of time, right? So it goes on up. 115 is 2015, 116, 2016, 117 is 2017, and 118 is 2018. Now, this is also based on what the heavens, the witness and the stars, right? Now, most of us have no really idea being citified. I call it shittified, right? Being shittified in the cities, in the concrete jungles, in slave ships. Mm-hmm. That's why ones have to look for a safe haven. You understand? And first of all, be born again. You understand? Repent and be born again. Because then the Holy Spirit will guide you even to some of the righteous among the Gentiles. But the first thing's first. If you do without that assurance, you understand, you're not going to be able to properly discern. You understand? And that will be woe to you and to whoever else is with you or follow you. So this is why a discernment is very, very necessary, and praying on it and seeking his guidance, right? So here she has, for 2011, is a possible first year of the Great Tribulation. Now, we're not saying that it is, and she herself is not saying that it is, but from all the positive signs, this is what it points to, from the best hermeneutics. And we checked out a lot of her research, and a lot of it is very much spot on. I mean, it's very, you is what I'm saying. I mean, we can learn some things from the Gentiles. They may be left-brained, we may be right-brained. Like, they need to get the right brain, you know, the feeling, the emotion, the human heart. We also need to be a little more analytical, you understand, and do due diligence, you understand, and be willing to write, take notes, you understand, do reports, you understand, share, disseminate this information, or, you know, with others. You know, don't be afraid. Be fearless. You understand, in the King of Kings and his Christ. So, she says this is a possible first year. Then in 2017, a possible last year of the Great Tribulation. Mm-hmm. Well, from our study of the scripture right here, we come to this hour of tribulation, right? And brothers and sisters, I is beseeching you, really, you know, download some of these videos, put them together in some series. You understand? Make that a ministry outreach project. You understand? Link and coordinate with I&I, but, you know, feel free and you know, distribute it for reasonable, for that which is reasonable, you know? And if you distribute it for whether a five or a tenner, you understand? You can also, you know, as well, you know, give away some free to certain ones and ones. Jah will bless you. You know what I'm saying? If you have Amen. So here in Revelation chapter 3, verse 9, which is like to chapter 2, verse 9. But in chapter 2, verse 9, it says, I know thy works, is speaking to the 316 A.D. church, roughly that period, which is the message to Smyrna in chapter 2 of Revelation, the period of the great persecutions, the great persecutions of the black Christians, of the early first century Christians. And I would like to bring up that chart right there with the black saints, the early black saints. A lot of them, we know their names, but a lot of us don't recognize, you know what I'm saying, don't recognize that they were black. Let's see if we can open up a window right here and search for that, you know what I'm saying, and bring that up. There's some other, yeah, some of that menorah is interesting, that whole study right there of the menorah. In fact, let's just bring the seven branch one up, right? The seven branch one up right there, right? And if you look at this one right here, this menorah, forget which website this was on, Shemot, which is Exodus chapter 37, verses 17 to 24. What is the menorah? The menorah is Yeshua. Is Yeshua is the light or the illumination of the world, the Medhane Olam. The Medhane Olam, right? Olam, right? Enlightened by the Ruach HaKodesh, or the Ruach Kodesh, but more correctly, the Ruach HaKodesh. You understand? So when you go to the Hasidim, the Hasidim, right? The Hasidim, which is Acts. The Acts of the Apostles is called the Hasidim, or what is referred to as the Hasidim. Now, we call that in Amharic, we call that, even though there's other ways of describing that, but that's like the holy ones or the saints, right? And this is what continually, you know, I say hallelujah, brothers and sisters. Why? Because in spirit, it showed I and I that, aren't you looking up the saints? Aren't you going to look up the saints, the black saints? Right, the black saints of early Christianity, right? The black saints of early Christianity. So we're going through some of the files that we have right here, and let's see if we can find some of the black saints. Oh, there we go right there, right? The African saints. Not the nine saints just yet. They come at a little later period, you know what I'm saying? And in particular of Ethiopia's story, right? It's saying that it can't open the file. But, you know, like they said, there's more than one way to, well, I'm not going to say that because, you know, our faith tells us that, you know, that whole thing about this, the cat and doing that wickedness to the cat. You got to, you know what I'm saying, that we got to prune our speech. Because a lot of this speech is getting us into trouble. It's keeping us in the curse. And it's preventing by, like, reverse, you could call it reverse magnetics. You know what I'm saying? It's preventing the blessing from manifesting. These are some of the nine saints. I mean, some of the saints, the early saints, not the nine saints of Ethiopia, but the early saints. It's called the saints of Africa, right? These are our saints right here. These are the early ones of Christianity. Many of them were martyred for their faith. You understand? For the true faith. And this is also what's kind of very... Oh, wow, it's astounding, amazing, it's interesting. You understand all of these various different saints right here. You can see even with the locks, with the hoodies, you understand, these sisters here, these brothers here, you understand? So we have these sisters here, these sisters here. This is, I think, Catherine. This is Isadora, you understand, or Isadora, you understand? Menace, or Menas, St. Maurice. You know what I'm saying? So these are some of the early saints of Christianity. You know what I'm saying? Who we are not told of. You know what I'm saying? They're whitewashed. You know what I'm saying? And that perpetuates, you know what I'm saying, the hate of the devil. You know what I'm saying? Because it robs us, you know what I'm saying, of our true reflection. You know what I'm saying? Of recognizing, you know what I'm saying, that true reflection. You know what I'm saying? In Christ up here, Yeshua. You know what I'm saying? See if we could bring that further down right there of Yeshua, All right, so these are some of the saints. I just wanted to show the eye of them this, you understand? So when we look at this menorah, right, this menorah right here, there's another something I wanted to show the eye, but let's just go through this area of scripture. Keep that up right there. So this is the time of the great persecution, AD 316, roughly around that period of time, AD 316, right? And it said that these things saith the first and the last, the Alpha and the Omega, which was dead and is alive. Sounds like what they've been saying of Haile Selassie the first, right? Some say he's dead. We say he lived. You understand? But he say in the word that which was dead, right? Remember we said I'm a man, I'm immortal, right? But in the way of Yeshua, that is just admitting the truth. But as you keep walking that, the mortality is changed to immortality in the way, the truth, and the life of our Black Lord and Savior, Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. So some get confused. They say, oh, he's saying he can't be Christ. He says he's a man. Well, doesn't the Bible say there's one mediator between God and man, even the man, Jesus Christ? Right? Doesn't it say that? And there's other places that says that acknowledge that he's a man. You understand? So see all these false things that we've been taught to rob us of our divine heritage. Verse 9 says, I know thy works and tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan. Because another Judaism was rising up in the world. You understand? While the true Judaism, you understand, or the Ethiopian Prolem, remember he said that the Jews were of the what? Of the race, right? Of the Ethiopians, of the black race. You understand? Of the original man, of the Adam. Mm-hmm. But now they are in the second Adam, right? It says, fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that ye may be tried. So we have a prison ministry. This is also a word here, Brother Othniel, right? Othniel. Ross Othniel, I and I seeking to reason with the I soon. Please be patient. Pray for I and I pray for the I and others also in the prison ministry. We haven't been, you know, negligent of that, nor have been, we received that word. You understand? And we're working towards that. And these teachings are also very much important because there's things we wanted to say, but we see them coming out, but his way. So please be patient and just prepare thy heart and thy mind. So it says, shall cast some of you into prison that ye may be tried. What do you try? You try something that is true, or you try something to prove it, right? Like you try gold. Somebody said this is 10 karat gold, or this is 24 karat gold, or whatnot, 16 karat, and you put it in the fire, right? If it burns all up, all you have is ashes left, you know somebody lied to you. Somebody didn't tell you the illness, boldness, right? It says, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days, right? 10 days. You shall have tribulation 10 days. It says, be thou faithful to death. Faithful to death, and I will give thee a crown of life. The King of Kings, Kadamawi, Haile Selassie, he was faithful to death. He kept the truth all the way. He ran that race. And Abu Qaddus has overcome, right? It says in verse 11, says, he that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith to the churches. You see, this was like the Ethernet. This was like we have the internet and we have the cell phones and the satellites, but there's also another form of communication that the world and the demons cannot penetrate. He that overcometh shall not be hurt, of the second death. You understand? So many of these went through great tribulation in their time for that faith, for that witness. You understand? And they even witnessed, you understand, the man of perdition. But then he was just a Roman god before they whitewashed him and made him Caesar Borgias. All right? So Revelation chapter 3, verse 9 says, behold, and this is in the message to Philadelphia, which is the true Ethiopic church, the church of his majesty. right? The real church, not the church today, that's the apostate church, but the church of His Majesty, the true church, that's in the professing church. So you have the professing church, it's the outer church, you know what I'm saying? But you have the true core of the true church, like the Debtoras, right? And like the Bahitawi, you understand? They're the ones being persecuted and have been persecuted, and we must pray for them and pray for their victory and pray that 10,000 angels, you understand, come down to protect those brothers and sisters, you understand, who are just like these Kedusan, these Chassidim, you understand, these true Chassid, right? Those true holy ones, right? Who are demonstrating by their faith that mercy of God in Christ. So verse 7, chapter 3, verse 7, we're in the church of Philadelphia. And what does Philadelphia mean, brethren and sister? It means brotherly love. This is what Kedamawi Haile Selassie has demonstrated, that true brotherly love. We can look at his Zemin, you understand, as that true Zemin, that true glimpse of greater things to come, you know. He is that true, you understand? He is that true man of peace, man of shalom. You understand? The true church and the professing church. So there are two churches. This is the Bible telling us this, right? Schofield Study Bible, right? And what it's saying there, we can affirm this by true history, or what they call dispensation, right? We're in a dispensation of the time of the end, right? But be not afraid, you understand? Behold Yeshua, HaMoshiach, right? Behold the King of Kings and His Christ, right? And as Christ says, if any come after me, deny, let go of your ego, you understand? Receive the true I Am, not who you think you are, but who He is. He who is who He is, Yah, Yahweh, right? And to the angel, the Melech of the church in Philadelphia, right? These things saith he that is Kedus, right? He who is who? What is he? He is Kedus, right? He is holy. He who is holy. You understand? He who is even Abba Kedus. Kedus Abba Tachin. And let's just bring that up here as well. Some say this is fake, right? And some say it's just a picture or whatnot. You know, even before Rastafari, true Rastafari, ever saw a picture of Abba Kedus, we was admitting that Jah lives. So really, you can misinterpret it, if you want, from a Gentile, white, Western, so-called mentality that doesn't amen, you understand? Or you can accept the basic paradigm, you understand, of the fact of the matter. Bring this one, yeah, bring that one open right there. We want to open this one right here, all right? Let's open this one right here, right? So Abba Kedus, Kedus Abba Tachin. Right? Abba Kedus. He who is who? He who is holy. Right? He's the Yehuda, or the Yoda, you can say, of the true Ethiopic Christian. Oh, we say knights, but a knight is a wetadev, is a soldier. These are spiritual soldiers. There's a spiritual warfare going on. Make no mistake about it. We're not talking about emanation philosophy. Go look up and find out what emanation is before ones want to talk. You understand, talk about, oh, that means this or that. Find out what it is and what it refers to. And that in itself is a revelation. You understand? And it makes so much sense of what we've already been picking up and learning, whether Theosophy, Helen Blavatsky, externalization of the hierarchy, Alice Bailey, and their so-called Aquarianism or New Ageism, Schism, right? But Abba Kedus, right? Abba Kedus, right? The Lion of Judah. You understand? The ancient Nazarene order of the Bahitawis and the Debtoras. Now, it's interesting to understand the Bahitawis, because the Bahitawis are like the true Levites, the Lewawion. They're like the true Levites, right? And the Debtoras are like the other priests, or the Kohanim, the Kohanim. So we in discipleship, in our discipleship, right, with Debtor is the composition, the notebook. You understand? In our Dekam is Amuritinet. You understand? Discipleship, we come in as that, as those Debtoras. Because see, the Debtor is an unordained, learned, ecclesiastic, or learned one. Now, some say, well, some of the Debtor has been up to some some stuff, you know, like they're on a spiritual level. And some say they're occultic or whatever. Because they're the ones that actually close the gates on this side, yoking that ones who have been dabbling in things that they should not have opened up. You understand? They're like the gate closers. You understand? They practice, some say, talismanic magic or so forth and so on. You understand? But really what they practice, I mean, this is not to say that some wolves might have not crept in among the sheep, but don't believe all these lies and slanders. Same thing with the Bahitawi. But you see why a lot of these lies are coming out right now is because more of the truth is being known, you understand, concerning Kedush Abatachin. You understand, concerning, you know, Kedush Abatachin. And since more of that truth is becoming known, there's a war. You understand? And now the war is condensating and descending from the spiritual level to the astral plane, to the psychical level. You understand? A psychic warfare. They try to psych you out. And when they can't psych you out, you understand? You have to suit up. You have to suit up and boot up. In other words, you know, you have to get ready for it. That's when the temporal warfare, you understand, comes in. That's when we get physical conflicts. You understand? But first, it begins spiritually. That's why we always have to stay up and remember that we are seated in heavenly places with Yeshua HaMashiach. Don't let them psych you out. You understand? And bring you down to so-called lower heaven, right? But it says, to the angel, the Melech of the church in Philadelphia, right? These things saith he that is Kedush, he that is true, he that is Eunet, right? He that hath the key of David, the key of David. He that openeth and no man shutteth. So the gates that the one who has the keys of David, Yeshua, and those in Yeshua, that which we open, that connects with that binding. Right? Whether you bind on earth, you bind in heaven. What you loose on earth, you loose in heaven. You understand? That connects right there. The key of David. Not keys, but the key. You understand? Which is another kind of a key. You understand? It's like the interpretation. It's like the fikare. The key of David. He that openeth, and no man shutteth. And he shutteth, and no man openeth. You understand? He shutteth and no man openeth. Well, a lot of folks don't recognize that there's been a high spiritual warfare going on in Ethiopia for a while. Mm-hmm. That's why some Ethiopians had to run out. And you see folks look troubled. You understand? They don't even know what it is, but there's a high spiritual warfare in Ethiopia, in those regions, when you understand what gates. Enoch speaks about these gates. Right? He speaks about these gates. But moving on, verse 8 says, I know thy works. Behold, look and see. Here it is. I have set before thee an open door. Right? An open door. That open door is the door of Christ. It's the door of repentance. Of coming to the foot of the cross. You understand? Coming to Yeshua. You understand? And no man can shut it. No man can, no matter how many, have you noticed, no matter how many lies they try to say against Yeshua, whitewash and everything else, they still cannot shut it. You understand? They cannot stop it. They cannot stop the testimonies, not even the Chinese and the Asians. And I think His Majesty had a special relationship with the Asians. Because otherwise, how is Mao Zedong going to all of a sudden turn around on his heels and create this new kind of Chinese communism? You understand? And see that building into Africa. Now, a lot of folks, you know, they look at it strange ways, but you have to see this in Yeshua. You understand? That's the open door. Mm-hmm. Walking through that door, guidance and protection. For thou hast a little strength. You know, we have a little strength as a people. A lot of us, look, we don't have much money. We don't have much resources. You don't have nothing, man. For real. You know, for real. It can make you break down and cry. Like, you know, some people are too big for that. But, you know, that's why some things don't come out. You understand? You got to let it out. You got to release it. You understand? You got to bind it, in other words. You understand? And thou hast a little strength and hast kept my word. We keep the word of the King of Kings. Mm-hmm. We keep the word, the testimony of Yeshua HaMashiach, Gittai Chini Jesus Christos, right? And has not denied my name. You see, we are the Rastafari that can say even Jesus Christ. And we know who we're speaking of. You understand? Some, you know, and they know about the false Christ, and know that Christ, the real Christ is black. They may acknowledge that, but they're caught up. That's what they're caught up. Indecision. You understand? Indecision. You understand? Between Caesar Borgias and well, they recognize this. They like how this looks, but they don't really receive the spirit and the truth. You understand? This is a shadow of what it really is. This is a shadow, too, of what it really is. You understand? This one transforms himself. You understand? He got to wear his heart outside because there's really no heart inside. You got to think about that. You understand? You got to recognize that. You understand? So it is as it is. You understand? It is what it is, right? So we don't deny Yeshua HaMoshiach's name. You understand? But we recognize which one is Caesar and which one is Christ. Who is Caesar and who is Christ? Remember the Israelites? And that's what we was trying to get to. Hallelujah. We recall. We're coming up. Actually, we're going over the hour. Are we going to go over the hour on this one right here? Should we go over the hour on this one? Some probably saying, yeah, go over the hour on this one. All right? So we're going to go over the hour on this one right here. Right? Now, what's interesting, there's a couple of the times Caesar's mentioned right here. It says, tell us, therefore, what thinkest thou? Is it lawful to give tribute to Caesar or not? Like some would say, well, what do you think? You think we should abide by Babylonian laws or you know, do things otherwise, right? And you know what Yeshua's answer was, to give unto Caesar things that are Caesar and render to God things that are God's. Render to what things are exiabihir abs. Thanks and praises in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Getachina methanatachin Jesus Christos. Then here, you know what I'm saying, he answers it furthermore. They say to him, Caesar's. Then he saith to them, render therefore to Caesar. So he showed the coin. He used the object lesson, right? Render to Caesar, give to Caesar the things which are Caesar's. Caesar lived by the sword, give him the sword. You know what I'm saying? He led into captivity, lead him to captivity. You know what I'm saying? Now you have to go to, Corinthians, where it talks about bringing down these strongholds, these spiritual strongholds. It's a spiritual warfare. The things which are Caesar's. And to God, the things that are God's. You know what I'm saying? So you got to recognize that because Caesar is a god of this world. That's why you have a Roman soldier on your American Express card. You know what I'm saying? So right here is where we're going to John. Let's go to John. Right? John. Let's be honest like Johannes. Right? So Johannes, which name means the grace of Jah, or the grace of he who is. Right? Jah means he who is. Ehyeh, or Ehyeh, mean I am. Asher, the one whom, right? Asher, Ehyeh, it means, or I, the living one, am who the living one is, right? And Yahweh Yah is Yah and Yah, Yahweh Yah. Like one would say Jah Jah, but you have to understand that there's an African king that was called Jah Jah, who a lot of the early Rastafarians, you understand, kind of got a little confused on because of lack of information. But we know their faith, the purity of their faith before the Father was accepted, even if they didn't have the knowledge that we have right now. Now, verse 12 of John chapter 19 says, and from thenceforth Pilatos sought to release him. So from a certain period of time, Pilate, Pontius Pilate in the Ethiopian tradition, right, not even tradition, in the Ritua Hymenot, in the right living faith, the right way to live, you understand, Pontius Pilate is a saint. But not in the Roman tradition because he basically turned his back on Caesar and accepted Yeshua. You know what I'm saying? So that's why the Roman Catholics and other traditions or Christian churches don't accept that. But we have the evidence. That's when we look into the Pontius Pilate's apocryphal book, which is called sometimes Nicodemus. You understand? What you call him, the epistle or the gospel of Nicodemus. It talk about when Yeshua went into Sheol to lift up the Adam and Eve and all the patriarchs. And that's when that one who he said, this day you'll be with me in paradise, was taken up into the kingdom. You understand? And was taken up, in that sense, into the millennial year reign. Some are looking at the millennial of Christ to be him coming back again. You understand? In the way that they believe. But the millennia, you understand, or a millennia has already occurred. You understand? And when you study the seven churches in Revelation, it becomes clear when you're able to recognize that each church is a certain part of the church age, which comes to an end at the end of the age. This is why there's a great apostasy of falling away. You understand? To really discern who's who. So it says, and thenceforth Pilate sought to release him, but the Jews, but the religious authorities, you understand, the religious authorities, they cried out saying, so the temporal ruler says, hey, there's nothing wrong with Rastafari, but the religious leaders say, oh, something is wrong with them. They're talking about black Jesus, and they're talking about this and that, and a lot of, we're losing people. People are coming out. They're being ekkalio. They're being called out. You know, that's what they're going to begin to say. You understand? But we have overcome, because greater is he who's in I and I than he who's in the world. You understand? He who's in Ehia, Asher, Ehia. Ehia Sharaehia, as the Ethiopians would say, saying, right, this is what they said, this is what the apostate Jews, and when we're talking about apostate Jews, we're talking about black people, if you please. We are, because look what we got today. We got the same ones, but they're not in Judaism, they're in the so-called Negro or black church. You understand? And they're most resistant to this truth, even though they can admit all the pieces of information when dissected and given and fed to them individually, but when you show them the big picture, they almost faint. All right? If thou let this man go, like if you let Yeshua go, thou art not Caesar's friend. You're not Caesar's friend. You're not Caesar's beloved. Now, who was God's friend? Abraham. Remember what Christ said? Christ said to them, ye are of your father the devil, for he was a murderer from the beginning. Cain killed his brother Abel. Right? And that was the beginning of fratricide, or brother on brother, brother killing brother, what we call today black on black violence. But you don't hear them preaching this from the pulpit. Or not even from the pulpit. They need to go out there and really do real mission. Start missionizing their own neighborhoods. How about that? You know, what would happen? The liberals would get all upset. You understand? Caesar's friend, right? Whosoever maketh himself a king. Now, before they were saying Yeshua, you making yourself God. Now they go from you making yourself a king, right? Whosoever maketh himself a king, and look what these liars say against our Godfather, Kadamawi, Haile Selassie. They say that, well, he wasn't really king of kings. He made himself a king, or he put himself on the throne, or he did this, or he did that, so forth and so on, right? But, you know, whatever, it still shows who they are when we look into the word, right? He maketh himself a king. Whosoever maketh himself a king speaketh against Caesar. Isn't that interesting? Because didn't they have, who was it? Herod? Wasn't Herod a king? Right? But see, Herod was a king that Caesar appointed. He was a puppy dog. I mean, he was a terror to the Hebrews and the black Jews, but he was a puppy dog to Caesar. And if you really want to see a little more about it, one of my favorite is I, Claudius. We got that series, too, in the educational doc vids and everything. Go check it out. I, Claudius, right? It's like about, what, 10, 12, 11 parts, I don't know, 13 parts. It's a couple of parts, but it's very, very interesting. It kind of shows you the Roman Empire at the time of Yeshua HaMoshiach. So you can see a split screen. This is what was going on in Judea, and this is what was going on in Rome, or in Rome, right? The Rome of the Caesars, right? So this is what the religious leaders said. See, the white Europeans, Cretans, you know, they made a big mistake, because they looked at the Jews, even the white Jews, when the priest, you know, how they told them that the Jews crucified Christ, and that there was these white Jews who were new converts. They know these guys were new converts. You understand? But you have to remember that Satan operates by certain, you know, divide and conquer. You understand? So they persecuted the European Jews, and this all led to the atrocities even of the Holocaust, or the Holocaust among the Europeans. But let's not forget about the Ethiopian Holocaust, you understand, by this same Caesar, the Tin Pot Caesar, or Mussolini, you understand, linguine, a type of pasta, you understand. Well, I like Zeti, I like this one, I like spaghetti, you understand, but some like Mussolini, all right? So see how it all breaks down even in, you know, prophetically. From this point on, Pilate tried to release him, right? From this point on, Pilate tried to let him go. But the Jewish leaders, with the religious leaders, the church leaders, they shouted out, "If you release this man, you are no friend of Caesar. Everyone who claims to be a king opposes Caesar." What kind of, see how hypocritical they were? They were down with Herod, or one of the Herods, Agrippa, or the loser, or whatever. You understand? They were down with Herod, right? And Pilate, when he heard that saying, he besought Yeshua, or he brought Yeshua forth. He brought Yeshua forth and sat down in the judgment seat in the place that is called the pavement. But in the Hebraic, right, in the Hebraic it's called the Gabbata. The Gabbata. Gabbata, right? It's called the pavement, right? The pavement. It's interesting. Even when you look at it Ethiopically, right? The pavement. Now, here it says, when Pilate heard these words, he brought Yeshua outside and sat down on the judgment seat in the place called the stone pavement. And Gabbata in the Aramawi, right, or Aramaic, right, or what we call like the Vulgar Hebrew, right, the Lower Hebrew, and the Ethiopic, the Higher. But we'll get into that as well linguistically, both of them Afro-Shemitic. So he sat in this place, the Gabbata, right, or the Gabbata, right, the Gabbata, right, and it was the preparation of the Fasica, of the Passover. Now, what is Nibiru? Nibiru is that, what, Passover comet, right? Mm-hmm. So what should we be doing at the right holy times and seasons? You know what I'm saying? That's why he gave us the Moedim. You know what I'm saying? That's why he gave us the Shabbat day as well. So his people, you understand, just like they were in the time of the Exodus, they will be in the right place at the right time and be protected. All right? And about the sixth hour, right, about the sixth hour, right, it was about the sixth hour. Now, the sixth hour, you have to understand that the time, it wasn't 6 o'clock. The time actually was, what, noon, right? It was noontime. You understand? It was noontime, the sixth hour. And Ethiopia still keeps this, that time is still faithful in that way. You understand? But apostasy, you know, we need to, you know, running out and bunning out, right? And he saith to the Jews or the religious leaders of his day and time, like we say to the church leaders of the Negro church, right? They're the church leaders. They said, "Behold your king." He said, "Behold your king," as we say, "Behold your king," right? "Behold the King of Kings." Now it was the day of preparation for the Passover about noon. Pilate said it was the what day? Right? It wasn't nighttime. It was the day, the 12 hours of the day. Pilate said to the Jewish leaders, "Look, here is your king." Right? "Look, here is your king." But they cried out, "Away with him." It's like when we say F him. Everybody say F that nigga. You know, that niggas. Right? "Away with him." They repeat it. You know how certain things are repeated? The word. Check out the word they're using. "Crucify him." They wonder why a black man has been lynched, right? Mm-hmm. "Pilate saith to them, shall I crucify your king?" And here are the infamous words, right? The chief priest answered, "We have no king but Caesar." That's why we say the Almighty has an interesting sense of humor. Would you say that? Psalm 2, right? Caesar Borgia. His name is Caesar Borgia. That they turn their back on the true likeness, you understand, and go after the Antichrist likeness. 1492, 400 years, 1892, the birth of the Son of Man, Lich Teferi. And yet some still will foolishly say, "So what?" You understand? Pray for them. Pray for them. You know, really pray for them. In the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, to the glory of the Father, that they will be, you know, healed of that blindness, right? So let's get forward in this word right there. That was the big point right there. So we don't deny his name, Yeshua. Then in verse 9, Revelation 3 and 9, it says, "Behold, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews and are not, but do lie." In other words, they are not Judah. You understand? Speaking of the ethnic, the seed people. So the race does matter to God. It may not matter to men and people. Remember Peter? Peter was called Satan. "Get behind me, Satan," because He favors the worldly interests, right? The worldly interests of things, right? It says that, behold, look and see, I will make them to come and worship before thy feet, right? As when we look at the feet of Christ, right? Okay, we're over that right there, but we look at the feet of Christ, to worship before his feet. Now notice what's at the feet too. It's the skull and bones, right? It's the skull and bones that's at the feet, because that was Golgotha, right? The place of the skull, the Ras Kill, right? The Ras Kill. Like they said, the cat skills, that was the Ras Kill right there, right? But the cat kills, the Lion of Judah, watch it, right? And worship before thy feet, and to know that I have loved thee, and to know that I have loved thee. So this message, this here speaks to the faithful, right? The Torah Jews, even the Messianic ones, the ones who also recognize, you understand, that difference even amongst them, that there are some who are in-laws. They are our in-law, because the Torah Jews or the faithful Jews are in-law as well. Now, the unfaithful ones, what they may call the Rothschild, what David Icke, I think, called the Rothschild Jews, that's who it's speaking about here, right? Because, verse 10, thou hast kept the word of my patience, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, which is to come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth. Right? And now here's Fikare Jesus, the Amharic only version, right? The first one, right? We'll deal with the raw translation. Right? This is the Fikare Jesus, and you see the man child right there. You know what I'm saying? Behold the man child, right? And also see Ethiopia is right there, the Horn of Africa, right? You see the horn, David's horn, the Ark of the Covenant. You know what I'm saying? And please, brothers and sisters, check out Ras Siddiqui's work and seek to support that right there, you know, with donations towards the tabernacle building, right, or the temple building for the dwelling or the tabernacle of the Ark of the Covenant. You can check that in some of our vids. Go to our main vids page and just put, I think, Ark of the Covenant. Look at the most recent ones, and it hopefully should come up, and you'll check it out right there. Now, this is the Fikare Jesus, or the interpretation, the explication of Jesus, of Yeshua. This was put out in the 43rd, right, in the 43rd year, right, the 43rd year of His Imperial Majesty's imperial reign on the throne of David. And the throne of David is the throne of Yahweh, is the throne of Jehovah, if you please, right, which is located in Ethiopia, which is the African Zion, the true African Zion. Prior to the Illuminati's godless and cruel dragon, so-called creeping coup against Christ in his kingly character and the end of days. So John's word, it tells us that there will be days like these. That's all when we look at September, right? We look at September, and we look at September 11th, right? And this is the cipher for 11 in the Ethiopic, or the Asherah And, or the Asherah And, the Asherah And, right? The Asherah And, the 11. It's very interesting also in so many ways that we can't fully go on to disclose and say at this present time. But it's interesting when you look at Bible numbers, like the Bible numbers, I mean, get a good list of Bible numbers, what the interpretation of Bible numbers, because the universe also runs, the spiritual part of the universe also run on numbers, because it's digital. You understand? Remember, by the finger of God, by the finger, and you notice how the one right there looks like a left-hand finger. You understand? Or you can even see it as a right-hand finger, making one. You know what I'm saying? You see that one right there, the Shema. We call it the Shema hand, right? The Shema hand, because in our right hand is the scripture. Our right hand is our sword. You understand? And in time of spiritual warfare, we salute, you understand, with that left hand to say, you understand, the number one. You know what I'm saying? It's just like in the military, one will have their right hand on their gun if they're right-handed, in the right hand, symbolically, right? And with the left hand, you signal. You signal with the left hand. You got recognized. So these are ciphers here. These are ciphers here. You understand? Very, very important. May the Holy Spirit reveal to you the real deal concerning the Ethiopic ciphers, right? And the whole link with the digital part of this universe, the digital part of this so-called matrix. Verse 10, it says, because, right, he's going to make them come and bow. And it's talking about the faithful, the Torah Jews, the Torah ones, the ones who are in-laws. You know what I'm saying? The Inja law, like a lot of Rastafari, the kibbutzim, the kibbutzniks in Israel. You know what I'm saying? And we say shalom, Rastafari, to you all, brothers and sisters. You know, link with I and I. Now it says, because thou hast kept the word of my patience. Patience, right? Patience, right? Patience is the faith of the saints. Because, see, the devil's game is to get you impatient. That's why they run the news. If not to make you fear, to make you fear and be impatient, or a little bit of both. You understand? You fear now, you understand? You be impatient later, or you be impatient now and you fear later. Give you that now or later, right? And make you a sucker, right? But his word gives us strength when we receive it. Because thou hast what? Kept the word of my patience. I will also keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth. And it says, behold, I come quickly. Hold that fast, that firmly which thou hast, that no man take thy crown. Now you have to remember, what is the crown? When we look at the full armor of Jah, we look at the full armor of God. The crown is the helmet, right? And the helmet is the helmet of what? Salvation. Don't let no man make you believe in, you know, any other than Yeshua HaMashiach, our Black Lord and Savior. You know what I'm saying? This is why we love His Majesty. We first saw His Majesty just as the Messiah, the Anointed One. You know what I'm saying? But through His testimony and through His work, you know, His demonstration, the Emare, you understand? Baruch. Through that, we recognize our God Father, you understand? Abba, you understand? And our big brother, our Lord and Savior, Yeshua. You understand? And we say that without any apology. You understand? No apology. You understand? So let no one take that crown, because many of the saints were tortured to death to make them say otherwise and make them do otherwise. See, so we have to recognize how serious, you can even say how serious this is. You understand? It says in verse 12, he that overcometh will I make a pillar in the temple of my God. Now, it's not saying that we have to look for the overcoming just in the future, but we have to recognize the overcoming in the here and now. We have to receive that by amen and amen, right? That overcoming. And you know how we do, brothers and sisters. We're going to have to, you know, rightly divide this word right here. So let's rightly divide this word, and let us talk a little bit about the overcoming, so you can recognize that we have already overcome. In 1 John, right, the epistle of 1 John, chapter 4, it speaks about the family and the world. It speaks about the children are warned against false teachers, ones teaching things in His Majesty's name that His Majesty never said, talking about the supernatural is a false concept. In other words, the spiritual, the false. These people are liars, or they're just foolish, you know, acting foolish. They're not building on that rock. You understand? Saying God is only visible, but not invisible. You understand? Distorting the person, and therefore the personality of the Word. And that's why they can't receive the Word into their own personality. You understand? And are troubled. The children are warned against false teachers. Beloved, wadajoch. Loved ones, lovers of the King of Kings and His Christ. Don't, my men, don't say amen. Don't say, yeah, that's right. At some things, you can't affirm it. See, when you affirm something, that God power in you, this is what the evil doers do. They make the righteous affirm wicked things. And this is what opens gates to bring it in. All right? So you can't affirm those things. That's why it says, believe not, or don't my men. Don't I woe. Don't say, yeah, that's right. You don't encourage people, oh, I'm just telling them such and such. No, you're injuring yourself. Don't amen every spirit, but try the spirits. So when some say the supernatural is false concept, they're lying when they say His Majesty said this. You know what I'm saying? They're lying when they denied, you know, He denied his. He never said He was Jesus, Yeshua. We can't clearly recognize that. But He is the anointed. He is the Mashiach, even the Nagush Mashiach. You understand? He is the anointed. When you recognize the foundation of Ethiopia, that David had a son named Solomon. Solomon had a son named David who renewed the kingdom of David in Ethiopia as per, you understand, that prophecy that we have in Psalms. Some of your modern black Jews, apostates, so-called church preachers and pastors, they don't recognize that the guy who was talking about His Majesty exposing something on Rastafari and so forth and so on, and he just rambled along. Didn't know what Sion was. You know, the between Sion and Seon. You know what I'm saying? One is the Z-I-O-N and one is S-I-O-N. All right? There's a big difference. You know what I'm saying? Check it out for yourself. But we are to try the spirits, to put them to trial. You know what I'm saying? Put them to trial. If they're not right, they're going to be in tribulation. You know what I'm saying? Try the spirits whether they are of Ha-Elohim, whether this is truly of God in word, you know what I'm saying? Sound and power. Or is it according to His word? Because many false prophets, you know what I'm saying, trying to tell you that Jesus and John the Baptist and Elijah were all the same person. What kind of nonsense is that, man? I mean, for real, this is false. It's false. It's logical. They're logical. Yes, they're very logical, but it's fallacious. Logical fallacies, right? Fallacies leading to spiritual maladies, right? Many false prophets are going out into the seclorum, the world. Now, the marks of the false teachers and the false doctrine or teaching of Christ's person, you understand, the false teaching of Christ's person, telling you, look here, that's Christ and that's Christ. Well, as they think they're Christ, then let them think this again. Because as they are of Christ, so are we. So what, you know, what doeth they to His glory? Hereby know ye the Spirit of God. Here's how we know the true spirit of Hashem, right, of Ha-Elohim. Every spirit, right, that confesseth that Yeshua HaMoshiach is come in the flesh is of God. Every spirit that confesses that. Because some say, you know, there's some false religiosities that teach people today that, well, He wasn't really a real person, you see. What it was that He looked like He was really there, you understand, but He really wasn't really there because, you know, they're lying to you. You know what I'm saying? You know? And don't affirm it. If they want to lie, let them lie. You understand? But don't affirm it. You understand? Stay in your heart and your mind. That's a lie. You understand? Yeshua, protect me from evil. Like it says, keep a guardian over your lips when the wicked is before you. The evil, the wicked are before you. You understand? But keep that sword, both the sword and the sword, but firstly the spiritual sword. You understand? If you got a temporal sword, but understand this in the context, because some folks might want to interpret this differently and say, oh, we said this. Nah, that's what you falsely interpret. You understand? Because you first of all have to know the Spirit of God. Every spirit that confesseth that Yeshua HaMoshiach has come in the flesh is of God. That means that recognize His true humanity is of God. Every spirit that says that. Because when they say, well, no, He's a spirit, but He wasn't really flesh, He looked like, that's emanation philosophy. That's what His Majesty said, that man is not emanated, right, from a deity. That's that emanation philosophy that says Christ wasn't really fully flesh. He just looked like He was there. Like He just looked like He was suffering. He really wasn't suffering. You understand? And that's blasphemy. You understand? Now, every spirit that confesseth not that Yeshua HaMoshiach, that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh, is not of God.
So you just listen to them. Let them talk. You know what I'm saying? And we, Akahed, walk John's walk, right? And this is that spirit. This is that spirit of Antichrist, whereof ye have heard that it should come. You've heard that it should come, and even now already is it in the world. Now notice something. John is writing this, I think, before his arrest on the island of Patmos, around 90-92 or so A.D. But he's writing this, and he's talking about that in the first century. So what could that be? That's the Roman godism thing. You know how the Romans were worshiping the Caesars as God, the Caesars. So notice now what more the Israelites were really saying when they said that. You know what I'm saying? What they was worshiping their father. You know what I'm saying? Their father who was a Cainite. You know what I'm saying? A Cainite, not a Bane Ha Elohim. So it goes on, right? He's like a fallen one. Cain is like the fallen, symbolic of the fallen angel, symbolic. And this is that spirit of Antichrist whereof ye have heard that it should come. And even now already is it in the world. It's that this spirit is there. But it would manifest over time. And roughly around the 14th, 15th century, we see it fully manifest right here. Notice this. We see it fully manifest in Caesar. Caesar. My name, or his name is Caesar. This one is Caesar. Caesar Borgias. 1492. You understand? Recognize that right there. Then they want to say, so hypocrisy of hypocrisy. It doesn't matter. And then he produces more counterfeit images. Why do they write like the Muslims do, just his name? You know what I'm saying? Why do they just do that? Oh, they might want to do that now when we bring forward the truth. You know what I'm saying? Too late. You understand? Repent while there's still time. Ye are of God, little children. Verse 4. Chapter 4, verse 4. 4 and 4. Ye are of God. You are of Ha Elohim. Baruch Hu. Blessed be He. You are of Hashem. You are of Kedamawi Haila Shalaseh. You are of the God of Abraham, Yitzhak, and Yaakov. You are of the God of the living, not the God of the dead. Little children. When we're born again, we're not born big. We're born as little children. We have to humble ourselves as a little child in the spiritual matters, in the matters of that rebirth. And it says, and have overcome them. We've already overcome. And said, you will overcome. You have. It's done, son and daughters. It's done. You know what I'm saying? So we're just working out what is already written, right? It says, because greater is He that is in you. You understand? In that true, when you truly have that inward, that inborn conception, and you bring it to true birth, greater is He who is in you than he that is in the seclorum, right? He that is in the world. You understand? The worldly one. He that's in the world. So that's what I want to show you about the overcoming. Let's just conclude this right here. All right? Bring this to a fullness, because we're in the overdrive, overtime, you know what I'm saying, right now, mode on this one. We like to keep it more or less to an hour or so limit, but sometime, of course, we go over. Now, what is meant right here, right? So we know that we, this is an overcoming. He says that him that overcometh will I make a pillar in the temple of my God, and he shall go no more out. And I will write upon him the new, the name of my God, of Elohai, of Elohai. He will go no more out. When you find the truth, it's like everything else is just so evident that it's, and you can put it to the test against the truth. You understand? You can tie truth, one hand of the truth behind its back, and the truth still wins. You understand? So that's how you know. So you there's no reason to go out, right? And the name of the city of Elohei, of Elohai, of my God, of Haila, right? Of Haila, right? Or Hailei, which is New Adesititu Jerusalem, New Jerusalem, the new city of the heir of peace. And it's that dual peace as one, as above, so below. That's the mystery of Salem, different than Salam, right? Which cometh down out of heaven. This is a heavenly thing, brothers and sisters, from Elohai, or Elohei, or Hailei, from my power, my God. and I will write upon him my new name. And this is why I and I have that new name of Ras Tefari, right? Learn what it means. It's very important. There's a very important meaning, you understand, of that name. And it's like a gift that keeps on giving as you start to learn and grow. You look at it and you see the layers of it. It's like a gem, you understand, that has, truly 1,000 points of light. When you talk about that, that's us. You know what I'm saying? That's us. That's the glorified body made manifest. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit, the Menfes, the Ruach, saith to the churches, right? Which saith to the churches. Now, that is very, very important. Now, this hour of tribulation, because I know that's what many of you all was waiting for, the math on that. Well, the math on the hour of tribulation, and here, let's just touch on this in the Fikari Yesus, right? The Fikari Yesus, right? Let us go to page, I think it's page 15 or so. Let us bring that up. Is it page 15? The Fikari Yesus, right? This is the Fikari Yesus in the Amharic. Let's go through this right here. Now, of course, it's the color version right here. It's not in print. It's the black and white that's in print. We show you that apocalypse image, which it looks awfully supernatural. You know what I'm saying? If you think about it, it's people falling out of heaven with wings. What's going on? Or is it a word picture? Is it like a dark saying? You know what I'm saying? That's to disclose his beloved ones, right? So let's go right here, and we're going to find something very interesting right here. That's the Meglech, the introduction, which explains to us concerning the King of Kings. Now here it says, of the Lion of Mark, Moan Besa, Moan Besa Negus, right? The Moan Besa, the overcoming king, in the Z Sit Efu Hulum Yilal Faritsuris, right? Well, we're going to go through more detail, but there's a part here on Nibiru that we wanted to put in, right? There's a part on Nibiru. Okay, here's what we'll do. Stay tuned, all right? Shalom Ras Tefari.